Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining me. And if you're not joining me live, thanks for watching the replay. I really appreciate it. Welcome to Brad's Live. Yep, we're live. I'm Brad. And there you have it. We are broadcasting today from the world headquarters of the Friedman Group right here in sort of rainy Denver, Colorado. And if you don't already know, the Friedman Group is an inbound email and social media marketing company. We work with professionals in regulated industries and business owners who want to take their business to the next level with a professional image online. That's what we do. I am really excited about my show today. I have with me the queen of messenger bots, RJ Redden. Oh, geez. I can't tell you how excited I am. And in just a minute, I'm going to bring her on. But before that, I want to just tell you a little bit about her. RJ is has a company called Black Belt Bots. Yes, Black Belt Bots. Triple B. And what RJ does is she works with business owners who want to bring more qualified leads to their doorstep. And her focus is working with messenger marketing, because when you use messenger marketing properly, what happens is you start engaging with people in one-on-one conversations, building relationships, and eventually they want to do business with you. And she can show you how to do this the right way. The other great thing about chatbots is that you can ask questions and get the answers you need to qualify those leads in order to determine whether you really want to do business with those people in the first place. And RJ is the best. She can help you do that. She's helping me right now. Our chatbot is watching along with you today. And if you type live in the comments, you'll get a message from our chat bot about 10 minutes before we go live every single week at 5 p.m. Eastern time. So, fun fact I discovered about RJ while I was doing a little prep is that she once spent 5 months in a foreign country where she didn't know the language just so she could learn how to explain things more effectively to people. I think that's awesome. But even more awesome than that is that the experience resulted in her getting kicked off a train once. No, the train wasn't moving, but nevertheless, it still happened. And maybe she'll share a little bit about that with us. Now, before I bring RJ in, I just want to say one more thing. I really feel blessed. Doing this show, I have been so fortunate to speak with some of the best and the brightest people on the planet. But even more than that, these people are good people. They are good-hearted. They are kind. They care about others, and they're willing to share their vast amount of knowledge with you. And RJ really epitomizes this type of person who I've been so fortunate to have on my show. She's the best. She is good people. And I'm really excited about speaking with her. And I know that you're going to walk away from this broadcast feeling smarter than you did when it started. So without further ado, let me bring her on and we will get going.
Hello. Hey.
Hi, RJ.
Hey, how are you, Brad? So nice to be on your show today. Thank you for inviting me.
I'm so excited that you are on this show, and I'm so excited I was able to dig up that fun fact about you.
That is a super fun fact, isn't it? You wouldn't think that they could throw me off a train, but they totally did.
Was that because they didn't understand what you were saying?
No, no, it's because I read the ticket wrong, that I bought the wrong ticket, and I thought it was good for the train that I was on. So here's how they do it in Germany. You buy your tickets or whatever, and you hop on the train, and then they have somebody come through and check your tickets. You don't have to buy a ticket and hand it to someone as you're getting on the train. So you can possibly get on the wrong train. Bought the wrong ticket. Didn't know it was the wrong ticket. And this lady was vehement. She was quite rude. She was so rude that the passenger next to me, after she walked off, said, "How will you cope with this?" He felt so bad for me.
Oh, really?
So basically, they told that I had to get off at the next stop. And then I had to find my way home from there, which was, it took a couple hours, but it wasn't that big of a deal. But yeah, I totally did get thrown off a train.
Oh, that's hilarious. I love that. I love that a lot. So what I leave out of the intro, what do you want people to know about what you do that I didn't already tell them?
I want people to know that bots are a terrible name for what I do. A tech person named them, and tech people are really good in a lot of areas, but they're not good at naming things. And when people hear messenger bot, they think about all kinds of things that don't really have anything to do with what a messenger bot really is. And I will tell you that a messenger bot, what it really is, it's a conversation between two people that is on steroids. It is a way to connect with somebody that I have always wanted, honestly. And you know as well as I do, you're in marketing. You've done this stuff forever too. You know that there are a lot of ways that people are teaching each other how to sell things out there that are really, at the end of the day, just make you kind of feel like crud. Like, you know, people telling me I am not a hugely outgoing person, except for behind a microphone, then it's all over. But people telling me you need to be more pushy with people. You need to be more assertive with people. You need to get your message in front of their eyeballs more. You're not doing this hard enough. You know what? When I do those things, I don't feel like me anymore. I feel terrible. You know, when I'm telling people, you know, when I'm sending in an email every 48 hours, I feel terrible. And so when I ran into messenger bots, what it said to me was, you can now send people messages that they consider valuable, and you can send them a lot less. You can give people value and shove yourself down their throats a whole lot less. And it took about 5 minutes to sell me on it.
Yeah. I mean, that's you described me as you just described you. I mean, I have been, you know, coached and mentored and mostly yelled at for not wanting to send that email every 48 hours or even every week. Just because, I mean, maybe it's because I don't like getting those emails every 48 hours and I don't like being bombarded with hard sell sales pitches. And I think in many ways, that's what attracted me to the messenger bots too, because I tell people all the time, people do business with people. They don't do business with businesses. And anything you can do to develop a relationship is going to help you sell your product or service.
That's right.
And using a messenger bot, wow. I mean, it's the best of both worlds. You get to have that automated piece and then you get to interact, you know, sort of on your own. I get messages from messenger bots all the time. Hi, this is the live me, not my bot. And you know, then you get to interact. So why don't we start with you just giving sort of a brief kind of what is a messenger bot to those people who are watching or who are going to be watching and don't have any clue what we're even talking about.
Absolutely. I would love to. So people use Messenger every day to talk to their family and friends, to talk to people that they care about. People will, and this is an interesting fact, Brad, that I didn't know until a few days ago, people will drop Facebook altogether and get off of Facebook, but they won't get off of Messenger because they want to be connected to their family and friends. They'll be mad at Facebook. They'll drop Facebook and go, I'm never getting on that thing again. But they'll keep the Messenger app on their phone because Messenger connects us to people we care about. So starting there, what Facebook did was it said, okay, you know, when we all have business pages, we all have a business Messenger account that's separate from our personal account. So a couple of years ago, what Facebook said is we're going to allow businesses to serve up a series of automated messages if they want to. Messages that answer questions, answer frequently asked questions, messages that maybe take people through a free mini course, messages that inform and educate, just like all of those, you know, the freebies, the give me your email and I'll give you this white paper type of stuff. Taking those things and instead of exchanging an email, just say, hey, I'm going to deliver this to you right in Messenger. And that's what I'm built on. So half of it is, you know, I've set up a bunch of automated messages to kind of introduce people to me and to what I do and gives them some valuable stuff. And then from that pool of people getting those messages, I pick out, I think this person would really respond to what I'm doing. And I ask them if they want to have a chat. And I take those automated messages and I start to fill them up with the human side. And then I get to know that person. Is this person maybe a collaborator of mine in the future? Is this person a referral of mine? Is this person, do they need my services? I start to have relationships with people rather than some static number on a page that's supposed to tell me the value of my business. So I fell in love with Messenger bots, like I said, in 5 minutes, because it allows me to treat actual human beings like, wait for it, actual human beings.
Wow, what a concept.
I know, in marketing. Isn't that crazy? I know. Yeah, you are not a number on a page. You are not, you know, this much in my funnel, then that'll go down to this stage and it'll be this much in my funnel. No, the people in my bot are people that I care about talking to. And they care about talking to me. And that is the secret of success with Messenger bots.
Right. So are you saying that we should be using Messenger bots instead of building landing pages that are asking for names and email addresses? Or is this just another tool in our marketing tool shed?
For me, it replaced some of the other things that I was doing that weren't working so well. Now, by no means have I fired my email provider. By no means have I quit doing any social media marketing but bots. No, what I did was I looked at what wasn't working. I looked at what my heart wasn't in, and I replaced that with what I'm doing in a bot. And it made a huge difference in my business. So yeah, if it's working for you, do not get rid of it. But if it's not working for you, and this might provide another perspective on an approach, if you're a reluctant marketer, I've got to write a book, Brad Friedman, The Reluctant Marketer. That's what I have to do.
I love that.
Oh my God. It is so true because I am the non-pushiest person in the world. And so that doesn't bode well when you're an individual marketing your business from home or whatever. It doesn't bode well because people will walk all over you. It's the world. It's the real world now. But I don't have to worry about that stuff anymore. I don't have to be pushy to sell anything. I haven't said a sales pitch in the year that I've been doing bots. I haven't had to give a sales pitch.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. Because of the back and forth conversation and the relationship building and all of that, you haven't had to do that.
I haven't had to do that thing that I used to have to do, which is I'm in the middle of a conversation. They seem interested. So then I say, hey, are you interested in hearing about my prices? And then they say yes or no. And if they say yes, then I say the prepared script that I have, including the reasoning behind all of my prices. And then I shut up and wait for them to say either yes or no. The most uncomfortable silence you can have with another human being, right?
Right. Oh, yeah.
I haven't had to do that in a year.
Yeah.
Because by the time people get to a phone call with me, they like me for sure. I'm not annoying to them. People that are annoyed with me get right back out of my bot. I don't have to worry about that stuff at all.
Right.
And they already know, like, trust me. And during that conversation, I can, and looking at their past chat history, I can say, this person would really be right for this area of my business. Or sometimes this person doesn't need my product at all, but this person and I could go really far together. So, you know, so then I pitch a collaboration. You know, Kim Boltzmann and I, you probably are aware of her. She's kind of in the same people we run around with.
Uh-huh.
That lady and I have never exchanged money for anything. But we're incredible collaborators, and she's my work wife. Let's just announce that right now. She lives in the same town. I'm going to tell you a story now. This is RJ's story time now. We live in the same town, and we belong to the Smart Success Business Network. And so there was a meeting last night, and we went. And the presentation, darling, was questionable. I won't go into it too much here, but she had brought snacks for her and I. And so we sat at eating raspberries out of a flat listening to the presentation. You know, I mean, it was such a wonderful time. I mean, those kinds of relationships are everywhere in my life today. Whereas if you look back a little over a year ago when I was doing different stuff and using different methods, I had a relationship where I was potentially chasing every person I knew for money. And that just gets on you.
Yeah, that's no fun at all, is it?
No.
Jeez.
It's no way to live, my friend.
Yeah. So what are the kinds of things that a messenger bot can do?
Okay. So there's a lot. I hope that you wore your comfortable shoes.
I'm sitting in a very comfortable chair.
Very good. You do have the headrest, I noticed. Very good, sir. So a bot can deliver a mini course that you have. You know, a 30-day roadmap to fill in the blank. A bot can deliver that really well. A bot can engage the members in your Facebook group who haven't done anything for very much in a while. You can throw out a challenge, ask people questions in a bot that they will answer because it's a one-on-one environment, not a public environment. And then ask people to celebrate their success in the Facebook community that you have. It really replaces a lot of the things that I used to do. I give people reminders to my live stream, and that's what we do for you as well. We remind people to live stream. By the way, people, to type live if you never want to miss another Brad's live show, and I know you don't. We live stream reminders, mini courses, 5-day, 7-day, 30-day challenges. Any way that you're using right now to engage folks and you feel like they're not looking at it, or they're not reading the emails, they're not downloading the materials, they're not participating as well, think about transferring that to a platform where people's eyeballs already are. How many times do you think you've looked at Messenger today, Bradness?
Well, let's see. It's 3:20 here in Denver, and probably 15 times, maybe more.
Yeah. You don't have to train people to look at Messenger. We're all already trained. This is not, I'm going to make an app and everybody's going to download it and look at it. Listen, unless you're game designing, don't make an app anymore. And, you know, I mean, I used to make apps for like conferences and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
Now I make event apps. I mean, I make event bots that give everybody all the information that they need, that connect them with people they want to connect to, that let them ask questions during presentations without having to go up to the microphone and be stared at by everybody in the room. Right. You can build these for events, online, offline. There's so many uses. It's absolutely ridiculous. And I don't want to bore you with the entire list, but trust me, I can make just about anything into a bot.
All right. So these bots, they sound awesome. It sounds like a tremendous way to market your product, your service, your course, your webinar, your event, whatever. But people need to subscribe to your bot in order to get the message.
Yep.
Which is why we keep saying type live in the comments so that you subscribe to our bot and get a message before every Brad's live. So how do we get people to subscribe to our messenger bot before our event, or get them in our, you know, get them subscribed so that they get a message about our course or our webinar or our challenge or whatever?
The first thing is not necessarily technology. You need conceptually, you need to give them a reason to subscribe. You've got to give them a benefit of subscribing to your messenger bot that they don't get anywhere else. So I'll give you an example. For me, the benefit of subscribing to my chatbot is that you get to ask me one-on-one questions in there, and you'll get a response from me. We can have a conversation. There's nowhere else on the internet we can do this. People don't hit reply on emails. Maybe there's some YouTube comments every once in a while, but most of them are rude anyway. You know, getting that one-on-one time with me in a bot is as simple as hitting a button that says schedule a call with RJ. I'll give anybody 30 minutes for free and answer questions about bots. That's the kind of thing to offer in your bot. There's got to be something special about the bot. If you're doing a bot for an event or something like that, then there's got to be something special about being able to access the information on the bot. And to me, that's the ability to ask the bot questions. So say you and I are at a conference together, Brad, and we're hungry, and we would like to go find some food in a city that we don't know, in a place that we don't know. So we can ask the bot about restaurants in the area. And then the bot pops up a PDF of all of the restaurants that, you know, hopefully segregated by price, right? and then you and I go off and get something to eat. Meanwhile, we haven't had to bother anybody. And I know that there's a lot of people pack websites with that particular information. And that's totally a legit way of doing things, except in order to find something in a website, we've got to get to the correct page and the correct area on the page. In a bot, all I have to do is type my question. The bot does the work.
Right, right.
That's the difference.
Yeah, I've been to a few conferences, especially recently, that have really encouraged people to sign up for the bot. They're putting the same or similar information on the website, but they're not telling you that. You know, they're assuming that, you know, if you're that person that's going to go to the website and look for that information, that you will find it. But they're encouraging you to, you know, sign up for the messenger bot for this conference or this event. I mean, we had an awesome messenger bot at Social Media Day Denver in June. And I mean, I think they had a website.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they had a website. I'm guessing I was there at one point, but there was really no need for me to spend a lot of time on the website, because anything I wanted to know, what time a speaker was speaking, or, you know, when there was when lunch was, what time did the after party start, which probably should have put that as my first question as opposed to the speakers, but
right,
I guess it's more politically correct. But all that information was in the bot, and it's very, very handy, very handy.
Well, and here's the other thing. Aside from in a website, you kind of have to pick around and search for the information, and it's not at your fingertips. The other thing is, what is in short supply at every single conference you've ever been to in your whole life, Brad?
Oh, geez. The list is endless. What are you thinking?
Wi-Fi.
Ah, Wi-Fi. Oh, absolutely.
So It doesn't take very much connectivity at all to be able to surface a result in a messenger bot, because that's the only thing that it's carrying. If you're trying to access a website for the information, you are trying to access the entire platter of everything that they have and then pick from that. With a bot, they're just going to give you the hors d'oeuvre that you ordered. And right. It takes a whole lot less, and a lot more people can access the information at the same time. So there are some technical reasons why it's awesome. But there's also some user friendliness reasons why it's awesome. Listen, I don't want to pick through your website right now. Just, I'm hungry. I need something to eat within my spending range. Can you give me that? You can ask a bot and it'll turn it up for you. We got all off on conferences there, but I just wanted to give you a real life pain point that we've all experienced one way or another.
Right. Right. So, several weeks ago I had Brian Kramer on Brad's live, and Brian is a big proponent of the human to human sort of movement. And I credit him for creating that hashtag H2H. And I know lots of people, me included, who feel very strongly about this human to human relationship building concept. And some of those people that I talk to are real hesitant to get working with messenger bots because they're not sure where you draw that line or how you draw that line. You know, certainly it makes sense to automate some things, but at some point it seems like there needs to be some human interaction. So how do we balance that and make that work?
So for me, there are folks that come to me occasionally that want a bot, that want to set it and forget it. They want to make it into some sort of a funnel where they'll, you know, get some phone calls at the end, or they'll get some people hitting the buy button at the end, and that's all that they ever want to do with it. When I get those folks in my pipeline, I direct them to other people that will help them with that bot, because I'm not the right person for me. This is, I can only speak for myself. There's a ton of bot teachers out there, but for me, the gold is when I can have a conversation with another human being, because by the time we've gotten to that conversation, a ton of filtering has happened. A ton of, okay, well, now I kind of know, you know, what you're wanting from a bot. I know how much you know about bots already. I know that you're responding to my personality rather well, or you wouldn't still be here. There's a ton of filtering that happens. I say, take all of that automatic conversation that you wish you could have every day. Take your top 7 FAQs and put them in a bot. And have your bot have the conversation, the parts of the conversation that are tedious and that you've done a million times, automate that part of the conversation and find a way to draw them in to having a conversation face to face or virtual face to face, because I got clients all over the world. So find a way. To me, the magic of it is when I join the conversation as not the bot, but RJ, having a conversation with a person about bots, seeing what it is that they need and see if that fits with what I have, or maybe we could do something else together. The live part of it is the magic. The automation is not. The automation takes care of what are the 7 questions that you and I ask and answer at every networking party ever. You know what I mean? Right. What do you do? Oh, that's interesting. Where do you live? How many family members do you have? How long have you been working at your job? You know, all of those cocktail party questions, right?
Right.
What if you could just, and I always say this, what if you could just skip to the fifth date? You know, good stuff's already happening at fifth date. You can skip all the preliminary. That's what a bot is like. That's, you get to skip all of the, and you get to put your best foot forward with people all the time. I don't know if you're shy like I am, Brad. Are you? Do you get that at networking meetings and stuff?
I'm not the best networker on the planet. I try real hard, and I've talked to people, and I've got systems, and I've joined groups, and I go into a networking event. I find somebody I know, and the number one mistake that you make at a networking event is doing what I do. Walk in the room, see somebody I know, walk over and say hello, and never leave his or her side the rest of the event.
Exactly. You just heard me telling stories about eating half a flat of strawberries with, or raspberries with my best buddy, Kim Boltzma. You know that I do the exact same thing, because I get in and I'm like, I don't know if my hair's right today. I don't know if I'm going to say the right thing. I don't know if I'm going to flub up and stutter, or if somebody's going to put me on the spot. As a person who works in marketing, people expect you to know everything about every facet of marketing. And I'm sure you've gotten that before. People will go, well, yeah, well, you're a marketer. How do you do this?
Yeah.
And you know what I mean? It's almost like a challenge. To me, what if you get to skip all that and put your best foot forward every single time? That's the magic of it, is that I can tell a bunch of people, hey, go to blahblahblah.com and sign into my bot and we'll start the conversation. And if they're willing and if I'm willing, we'll pick up where stuff gets good. So that's kind of how I think about it.
Right, right. So let's say we buy into this concept of using the Messenger bot as a marketing tool. How does using the Messenger bot affect our marketing strategy? So how are we going to change our strategy or add to our traditional marketing strategy some strategy that deals with these Messenger bots?
Yeah. So for me, the Messenger bot has replaced the little customer chat that I used to have on my website. It has replaced some of the email that I send out. I took a course that I was a course. You know, I took a PDF that I had people download as a freebie. I turned that into a little mini course you can take on my bot that just gives you one piece of information at a time, which in today's world, people digest that a whole lot better. Right. And so I've taken little parts and I've added them into my bot. And each time it's an experiment. Sometimes I add something into the bot and nobody goes down that path, or very few people do, and I get a lot of drop off. And I say to myself, well, I'm gonna flip that back around to what I used to do, because that's not working. And sometimes I totally just adopt a new practice into my bot. I'm doing it, you know, it's been a little over a year now that I've been doing bots. I do this a little bit at a time. If you meet somebody that urges you immediately to drop everything you're doing and completely turn everything around into bots because they're going to make you a star, listen, I want you to run away from that person. Bots are new. We are very excited about them. I'm very excited. Sometimes I think about them in the middle of the night. That's how excited I am. But we are all, it's the Wild West out there. We're all, you know, we're all doing our best. We're all seeing what works. And so if you're thinking about adopting bots in your overall strategy, start here. Pick one thing that ain't working for you and see if there's a way that you can put that inside a bot instead. See if there's a way that you can take some material that maybe has been great in the past, maybe a blog post, maybe a PDF download that you've had. think about ways that you can take that same material that you already have. You don't have to make anything up. Put it into a bot and have it deliver that way. And then when the stuff, you know, when your 5-day course or whatever it is has run out, message that person 2-3 days later. Hey, what'd you get out of that? What action steps are you taking because of that? And then start that conversation. Invite them to a one-on-one if that's, you know, if you think that that's going to be viable with that person. Gain know, like, and trust in that bot. And then by the time you get to the conversation, it isn't about, okay, how am I going to sell this person? It's much more about, this person is delightful and I love them. So how am I going to put them into my circle? Where do they fit?
Right. So we could be thinking about, so let me give it, let me see if I can give an example from me personally. I have a PDF that I've been sort of peddling, 5 steps to amplify your social media.
Yes.
If we took that document and broke it up into 5, 7, 10, whatever, different messages, I wouldn't have to be driving people to a landing page and asking for a name and an email address to download that PDF. Instead, I'd have people who are subscribed to the bot getting maybe a message a day for 5 days, and getting those 5 steps to amplify your social media via the bot. Is that sort of what you're saying?
That's perfect. That is perfect, because one of the things that we all suffer from is the same thing that we don't get at a convention: bandwidth. When I used to give people, you know, a full page of this is awesome information, I just love for you to have it, that it just seems to fall flat because people can't fit it all into their heads at once. But when you surface one thing at a time, when you say, hey, Brad, you could amplify your social media today. I'm going to explain to you what action I want you to take. I'm going to tell you exactly how to do it. And then I'm going to give you this. I'm going to give you this assignment. And then I'm going to check up on you later. And I'm going to give you something else tomorrow. Are you willing to go along this journey with me? That's a whole different attitude. That's me respecting that you have very little bandwidth to deal with anything new, because you're an entrepreneur just like I am, and we both, you know, work stupid hours and do the things that entrepreneurs do. I have my snacks right here just in case anything goes wrong. Do the things that we do, eat at our desks, work all the time, stupid hours, all that kind of stuff. You don't have enough bandwidth for the 5-page PDF anymore. We have a little bit at a time. And when I respect that, and when I work within those boundaries, that builds the know, like, and trust factor with you immediately. I don't even have to be sitting there to build know, like, and trust with you.
So we're really giving people what they want. Yes. They want bite-sized, snackable information that they can get, digest quickly, and get back to whatever it is that they're doing.
Exactly.
So that's probably one of the reasons why it's such an effective means of marketing.
Yes, that is exactly it. That is, do you know the survey company Typeform, Brad?
Yeah, I've heard of it. Uh-huh.
Okay. So that is that's a survey company just like what's the other one? The monkey one. There's another Survey Monkey.
Right.
So they deal with surveys too. But the reason why Typeform is so incredibly successful is SurveyMonkey will let you see the entire form of 10 questions or 20 questions or whatever, or sometimes they'll split it up into pages or whatever. Typeform, you answer the questions, and as you're answering this question, you can't see any of the other questions.
Uh-huh.
One at a time, you're forced to consider these things in their entirety without other things coming in and trying to give you, you know, input. And because of that, their forums are very, very successful, and they get a better fill out rate than your normal SurveyMonkey 20 questions. A bot does the same thing. I am only going to ask you to look at the information that is in front of you right now. I'm not going to ask you to focus on 1,000 different things. I'm not going to ask you to look through 1,000 different things to find what you need. I'm going to allow you to type in a question and I'm going to return you the answer because I'm prepared and I know these answers already. And that, you know, even that little connection, ask a question, get an answer, even though you're not there, even though that person knows they're talking to your chatbot and not you, it still builds know, like, and trust with you. And that's what we want out of marketing. In the end, that's what we want.
Sure, sure. So let's say that I'm watching this broadcast or I'm watching the replay and I'm liking what I'm hearing. I know that this is something that makes sense. How do I get started?
So a couple ways to get started. And if you've never experienced a chatbot before, then I have one for you that introduces you to bots. It tells you, you know, what bots are, what they can do. It shows you the software that I use to build them. It's a 7-day free mini course. And all you have to do is go to checkoutmybot.com. Yes, I totally bought that URL along with all about that bot, which I haven't used yet, but that's a different situation. Anyway, checkoutmybot.com. Go there. Get that stuff sent to you in Messenger. Allow Spinning Dragon, my chatbot. She's a little ninja. She's got a little blue pajama suit with a zip up. She's very cute. Spinning Dragon will deliver you the mini course over 7 days. Experience that. Think about how different that is than your usual stuff. At the end of 7 days, if you make it through all 7 days, you can schedule a free Ask Me Anything call with me. It's there for you. It's there for everybody to take advantage of because I don't want to be a lecturer ever again. I taught college once. It was a great experience, but I'm done being a lecturer. What I want to do is I want to get to the heart of the matter and help you figure out what's going to be right for you. So I do Ask Me Anything phone calls. If you make it through all 7 days of the mini course, if you know everything, if you've at least got that working knowledge, then we can have that AMA call and I can direct you toward whatever resources will help you in your bot mission. That's a great way to get some working knowledge pretty quickly and just see how everything works. I think that's, you know, I try to explain bots to people a lot of times and I know that they love me and they're terribly interested, but I can see that glaze. And I know they're not listening because it's gone over your head. Sometimes you have to experience things to be able to say, oh, now I get it.
Right.
And so that's what I'd urge you to do. If you don't know anything about bots, but this sounds real interesting, go see what I mean. Go to checkoutmybot.com.
Okay, that sounds great. And I know that you also have a Facebook group where you share lots of information and the people in the group share information. Is that another place you would suggest people visit to learn more about this?
Yeah, absolutely. You can go to Black Belt Bots Community on Facebook. It's aptly named. I know not totally imaginative, but there you go. Hop on over to Black Belt Bots Community and join us. We'd love to have you. There's going to be some stuff coming up in there. I haven't done very much lately because we've all been in summer. You know how it goes. But there's some stuff coming up that's going to be great and challenging and hopefully a lot of fun.
Great. Great. So after I do the 7-day checkoutmybot.com and I want to learn more, I'm ready to take that next step and maybe have you walk me through the steps of building my first bot. Do you have some kind of program or something where we could do that?
I do. It's short and sweet. So it's a one night only. I do this one time a month. But I help people sign up for ManyChat, I help people build their first reminder bot, just like everybody gets for this show if they type in live in the comments, which if you haven't done that, do that now. I help people build their very first reminder bot, and then I teach them how to build engaging broadcasts that will bring people out of the shadows, get them answering questions and having conversations with you. So it's a real basic, like a reminder bot is the bottom basic line you can have. But especially if you are a live streamer or if you're a content creator of any time, and I know you talk about content a lot, Brad.
Sure, absolutely.
If you're a content creator, you got to get eyeballs to that content for it to work for you. A messenger bot will get eyeballs to your content. So if you're interested in building a reminder bot, my next class is August 20th. It's a Thursday. And to sign up for that, it's $97. It's 3 hours of me. Everybody gets the replay recording. If you're interested in that, go to
September 20th.
September, yeah.
Okay, yeah, you said August, and I'm looking. It's August 22nd.
Okay.
September 20th. How do we sign up for that?
Startyourbot.com.
Oh, okay.
And that'll go directly into my chat bot as well, and Spinning Dragon will help you sign up for the class.
So when you were talking about that, you mentioned Many Chat.
Yes.
And I think that's the first time we've talked about Many Chat today. So maybe we should, you should take a minute and tell us about Many Chat.
Totally. So when I thought to myself, I need to get into building these bots immediately, I reviewed several pieces of software. Many Chat is the most user-friendly of everything that I reviewed. And that's why I recommend it to people. I don't think that you should have to know coding and technology to build these things. In fact, most of the people that I work with, they don't know that stuff. So I wanted to have something that people could pick up reasonably quickly and get started in their bots reasonably quickly. So ManyChat is it. It's got a lot of features. It's super inexpensive. It's $10 a month for up to 500 subscribers. That's the pro plan. They've also got a free if you want that. It's a very good place for beginners to go. And so that's why I recommend that.
Okay, so we can go there and use that instead of having to learn how to write code, and we could use the drag and drop. And
It is about as easy. Once you get used to where things are at and how to get to certain areas on the interface, you can do this. If you can edit a PowerPoint, you can run ManyChat.
Really?
Yeah.
Very nice. Very nice. And people could go to your website to get all kinds of information about this too, right?
All kinds of information, ridiculous amounts of information. I do 2 live streams a week that I embed on my website and make a blog post out of. There are many, many blog. If you just want to swim in this information and get familiar and just do it all that way, blackbeltbots.com. There's a page called the Bot Signal that has all of my live stream shows on it. And that will provide a wealth of information. So go there if you would like.
Okay, that's great. And as we've discussed, and as some people know from my history, your bot signal is very similar to my formerly known as BAF signal. And I love the name, obviously, just because it's so close.
I do sometimes call you a bath man when I message you and when I'm writing down in my notes, bath man, I write notes about you in bath man. So
I've got the license plate. So everybody, all my good friends call me bath man. So
sweet.
You might as well be on that list too.
I'm so happy with what you're doing. I think that the world needs it so badly. Particularly with, some of the legal aspects of some stuff. I've just seen people get into some really tight, and it's not everybody. You're right. I mean, there are a lot of people that don't necessarily need it, but man, when you get into a tight spot with some of this stuff, you got to call somebody. Who are you going to call? You're going to call the bath man. So,
well, you know, the biggest issue really is the people that don't want to do things online because they're so worried that there's going to be a problem, that, you know, they're going to violate some regulation or they're going to do something. That's what's so troublesome or sad or whatever the right word is, you know, it's acting as a deterrent to marketing the way that we're marketing today. So
I know.
Yeah, that's a very tough thing. That's a very tough thing. So what do you want to tell people about messenger bots as sort of a final parting message before I let you get back to the many more important things you have to do today?
No more important than talking to you. Well, I would love to tell people, if you are a reluctant marketer like I am, if you are shy about promoting your own products, if you spend 6 months building the most beautiful online course that there ever was, and then when it comes time to market it, you go, you might want to think about trying some messenger bots. Messenger bots might be that conversational approach might fit you like a T. So don't listen to people that say you have to get into messenger bots now. If you don't do it right now, then you won't get rich like me. Get on the ground floor, blah, blah, blah. Don't miss the train. Don't listen to fear mongers anymore. Let me tell you, the reason to check out messenger bots is because it's the first marketing tool that I know of that allows the people that are on the receiving end of it respect and space, and it allows you to market the way that you want to market, and you can talk your talk. You don't have to copy anybody else's funnel to success. This can be all you if you're willing to give this a try. Go check it out. Go check out any of my things. Go check out ManyChat. Do yourself a favor and start looking into a different way to market.
Awesome. That's great. That's a great message. You said that. Well, I'm wondering if maybe you've said something similar before.
No, but you know what I just thought as that came out of my mouth was, I got to get to the replay and then type that out, because that was amazing.
That was gold. That's so funny. I see that. Wow, this is awesome.
Beautiful things happening on the Friedman Group show today.
There you go. Well, thank you so much. I so appreciate you coming on today and sharing some of the wealth of knowledge you have with the viewers today. And I hope that I can talk you into doing it again sometime in the future.
Anytime, any old time.
Awesome. And thank all of you for watching today. Don't forget, even if you're watching the replay, you can type like in the comments. And in the future, you'll hear from our messenger bot a few minutes before we go live, so that you don't miss out on another guest or maybe a return appearance from RJ. Like our Facebook page while you're there. I plan to be back next week. Same bath time, same bath channel, 5 o'clock Eastern time for another great show. And in the meantime, do something nice for someone else today. Thanks.